The United States of America has always had close connections with the countries of Europe, and the closest of them has been with England, in spite of two wars between England and America. But America has always had another good friend in Europe, the people and the country of France. A Frenchman, Lafayette, helped the Continental Army fight the British in the War of the Revolution. Later, the ideals of the American Revolution were reflected in a revolution against their own king by the French. And as the years went by, Americans and Frenchmen found many things on which they agreed. Many things. Then, one day, a French historian who was a very great admirer of the United States, an historian by the name of Edouard de Laboulaye, suggested that this long period of friendship between America and France be remembered. De Laboulaye suggested that France give the United States some kind of monument. Another Frenchman, Auguste Bartholdi, came to America in June 1871. He took a look at the great harbor of New York City, a big, bustling, busy seaport. And Bartholdi suddenly saw how the idea of a monument could become a reality. Bartholdi pictured a huge statue, a new colossus, standing on that island in New York Harbor, a symbol of America's open door. It would be a statue of the goddess of liberty, facing out to the open sea and holding a torch, a lamp, a great light that could be seen far out in the ocean to guide and welcome the peoples of the world through America's golden door. The Statue of Liberty is a symbol of the long and deep friendship between the people of France and the people of the United States. But even more, a symbol of freedom itself. In truth, a Statue of Liberty, its blazing light shining out in a dark world. A glowing symbol of the meaning of the words of a poet, which are engraved on a tablet within the pedestal on which the Statue of Liberty stands. The poem was written by Emma Lazarus, titled The New Colossus. Not like the brazen giant of Greek fame, with conquering limbs astride from land to land. Here at our sea-washed sunset gate shall stand a mighty woman with a torch, whose flame is the imprisoned lightning, and her name, Mother of Exile. From her beacon hand glows worldwide welcome. Her mild eyes command the air-bridged harbor that twin cities frame. Keep ancient lands your storied pomp, cries she with silent lips. Give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses, yearning to breathe free, the wretched refuse of your teeming shore. Send these, the homeless, tempest-tossed to me. I lift my lamp beside the golden door.